Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's video is all about the things that our experts can't explain fully, at least at this moment in time. And this sometimes lack of information is partly the reason for my interest in geology, because I know that experts cannot be expected to explain everything, and that's just how things are. And I'm saying this because today's subject is one of those tricky systems that we don't know so much about, or the West Volcanic Zone that stretches all the way under the glacier Langjökull, or Long Glacier in English, and the famous volcano shield Skjaldbreiður is also a part of the story. This is how it looks from the Þingvellir National Park, and the glacier is behind it. This volcanic zone has been classified as quite inactive, and in fact I've heard an expert describe it as a dying branch of the plate boundaries, although there is always some seismic activity there. Mostly minor events that we hardly notice, like a month ago, when this earthquake swarm started, it was explained as intraplate earthquakes caused by stresses within the tectonic plate, and we were fine with that until this activity continued to increase, and it is very localized and does not follow any known fractures there. So a volcanologist was just the other day opening up the possibility that this could be something else. He could have been more clear about this, but it seemed to me that he didn't rule out magma movements there. And magma on the move, that is big news. And in this same interview, he was also mentioning increased activity in the mantle plume under Iceland and warning us that we might be seeing increased volcanic activity because of that. And that is also big news. And I've also seen this question flying around, or if this seismic activity by Langjökull Glacier has anything to do with the activity on the Reykjanes Peninsula, since after all we are not far away from the plate boundaries where they run along the peninsula. But as for science, we don't have any historical records to support that, so once again we have some geology textbooks in the making in front of us. And the reason why this alleged connection between those systems is being discussed now might be that over 500 earthquakes were detected not far away from the area that is shaking now, from December 2021 to February 22, or shortly after eruption number 1 on the Reykjanes Peninsula came to an end. The earthquakes back then were also very localized, so it is most likely the timing that might be the reason why experts seem to be wondering if this part of the plate boundaries is waking up in some way. But that's not all. One of our most quiet systems has been waking up quite gently, actually, or the Snæfellsnes volcanic belt. It's 2 years since the earthquake started there, and experts said back then that it might be the start of a development that could take even decades to develop into an eruption. And earthquake swarms are still detected there every now and then. Enough for me to go filming there last year, so I would have some stock footage to use when I need it. And I only found out that I would need to spend more time there. This volcanic belt is 90 km long and it contains out of this world formations. And we can only see a small section of this volcanic belt from the highways. So we have a warning there. And it's nothing new that we are getting warnings. Our glaciers are shrinking, and that will lead to heightened activity. We have been warned about that for a long time. And then we have the Reykjanes Peninsula, or a period of frequent eruptions that we can expect to go on for up to 300 years. And we have already gone through 3 volcanic eruptions in 28 months, which is far above the Icelandic average, which is an eruption every 3 to 5 years. So when we look at this package we have, melting glaciers, increase in mantle plume activity, old and quiet systems waking up, and then of course the Reykjanes Peninsula, this looks a bit like a nice first draft for a disaster movie script, since there are so many of our major systems that are getting ready as well. Like, I have this video online called What 7 Volcanoes Are Getting Ready for an Eruption, And when I will remake it in perhaps 6 or 8 months, those volcanoes could be 8 or 9. But we must also take into account that volcanoes might be removed from this list, like the volcano Öræfajökull that seems to be cooling down after some warnings a few years back. But it doesn't change the fact that the Icelandic volcano scenario looks like never before. And I was thinking, was it careless of me to visit the Askja volcano the other day? Some experts say it's okay, that is the official stand now, but I know of at least one volcanologist who is against it, and wants the area closed. So I'm going to wait with that story for a few more days since I need some information, and all I can say now is that I did not waste any time up there. And let's go back to where we started. The message of the day is that these earthquakes at Langjökull Glacier continue, and it would be fun to hear what experts and armchair experts on my channel say about this in the comment section. And finally, I want to mention how strange the earthquake map from the Reykjanes Peninsula looks to me now. Especially how fast the seismic activity seems to be increasing again after the eruption came to an end. And the earthquakes are moving to the east now. I might be wrong about this, but I think that this is showing us how far away we are from the old norm before 2020. And the next big event might be sooner than we think. And it would not surprise me if the next big event would be closer to the capital. So my next video will be all about our backyard volcanoes. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland. Thank you.